Hello everyone, welcome to Mechanical Vibration Lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the special case of arbitrary force, means stair force. So, first of all, we'll brief about our learnings from the last lecture. So, in last lecture, we discussed about the response of single degree of freedom system for arbitrary force. So, this is the dynamic equilibrium equation for any single degree of freedom system, mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx is equal to ft, and these are the initial conditions. And arbitrary force, as we know that the any harmonic force can be represented as harmonic force, and any arbitrary force can be represented as randomly varying force. So to find out the response against the arbitrary force, first of all, we'll define the arbitrary force that can be defined as this one. And after that, we define the impulse at t equals to tau time. So impulse at t equals to tau time is f tau multiplied by d tau. And from that, we pick the unit impulse. If we pick the f tau multiplied by d tau is equal to unit, so this is highlighted by red color, this is unit impulse. So from this unit impulse, we find out the initial conditions at t equals to tau time. So we know that t equals to tau time because before tau there is no response. So initial displacement at zero. And in the last class we discussed at x naught velocity at tau time is 1 by m. So we considered that this impulse created a free vibration problem or created initial conditions, and cause of these initial conditions there is a free vibration of the system. So then we find out the response to unit impulse that we designated as ht minus tau, and this is the response because of unit impulse. So before t there is no response, and after tau there is a response because of unit impulse. Then we find out the response to impulse, and response to impulse dxt is f tau, or you can say response because of unit impulse multiplied by impulse. So f tau multiplied by d tau, this is impulse, and this ht minus tau is response because of unit impulse. Then we find out the response to all such impulse, and this is arbitrary force, that xt is equal to integration from 0 to t and ft ht minus tau multiplied by d tau. And this was our response to arbitrary force. Because arbitrary force is a series of impulse of different values, so from this graphical representation we can understand the arbitrary force. Suppose this was our first impulse, this is second impulse, this is third, this is fourth, and so on. So this series of impulse is arbitrary force. So to find out the complete response because of the arbitrary force, or we can say response to all such impulses 0 to t, we have to integrate this. This is the response because of impulse. So from here we find out the free vibration response of damped system, that was 1 by omega d integration 0 to tau f tau e raised to power minus zeta omega n t minus tau and sine omega d t minus tau into d tau. Before t time, here you can say time must be greater than or equal to tau, because before t there is no response. And response of the undamped free vibration we find out as 1 by m omega n integration 0 to t f tau sine omega t t minus tau multiplied by d tau. So this is the response for undamped vibration, and this is response of damped vibration for single degree of freedom system. So now we'll find out the response to units or step function. So first of all, response to step force. So first of all, we'll define the step force. Step force means you apply a force suddenly of fixed magnitude, and that force will long last up to we want to respond. So this is a step force, and this value is F node, and it will remain constant throughout time. So this is step force. So we can say the F T is F node. This is our step force. So we can, for this we can write the response of the undamped system. So for this we can say response of undamped system against unit or step force. So this is xt at f tau will replace the value of f naught, and this is 1 by m omega n 0 to t, and at the place of f this was our f tau sine omega n t minus tau d tau. So at this place we'll replace the value of f naught. So this becomes 1 by m omega n 0 to t f naught sine omega n t minus tau d tau. This is response of undamped system against step force. So if we solve this, this becomes f naught by k 1 minus cos omega n t, and this f naught by k here, this f naught by k is nothing but it's a static deflection. So to understand the value of this f naught by k or the meaning of f naught by k, if we take a example of cantilever beam, and if we apply a force F naught, so this beam will deflect something like this, and it will create a static deflection. So this static deflection can be given as F naught L cube over 3 E I, or you can write F naught over 3 E I over L cube. So this is the value of K. This is the equivalent stiffness of this cantilever beam. This is static deflection. So this is nothing but it's a K, or you can say equivalent stiffness of cantilever beam. So this is the static deflection, static part, and this is, and this one is dynamic part of response. So now we'll understand how we arrived at this formula from this part. So to understand this, we'll solve the integration problem. So for this, our problem was 0 to t sine omega n t minus omega n tau d tau. We skip the constant part, that was 1 by m omega n. So we'll solve this part only, because this is constant. So we'll use it later on. So this can be written as minus 0 to t minus sine omega n tau minus omega n t d tau. So now we will substitute u equals to omega n tau minus omega n t, and du over d tau equals to omega n, or we can say d tau equals to 1 by omega n into du. So we'll replace these two values, d at the place of d tau will replace 1 by omega n du, and at the place of omega n tau minus omega n will replace the value of u in this equation. So on substitution we'll have now, we will solve this becomes minus 1 by omega n 0 to t sin u du. So again this is constant, so we'll solve this only. So now we can say, now we will solve 0 to t sin u du. So if we solve this, this is a standard integration, so you can say this is a standard integration, and this becomes minus cos u 0 to t. Or you can say, if we use the complete value, because there was minus 1 by omega n, so this becomes cos u over omega n t 0, because earlier this was minus 1 by omega n 0 to t sin u du. So we solve this and we got this value, and if we replace this value into this, then we'll have this. So now we undo our substitution. Now undo our substitution, and that was u equals to omega n tau minus omega n t. So we will have cos omega n tau minus omega n t over omega n, this is 0 to t. So if we replace the limit values, then we will have 1 by omega n minus cos omega n t over omega n, and again this becomes 1 by omega n can be taken as common, and this becomes 1 by cos 1 minus cos omega n t. And so this complete, if we replace these values, this value into this equation, this was our equation, and our equation was, we can say that was xt equals to 1 by m omega n 0 to t f naught sin omega n t minus tau d tau. So we solved this part, we have solved. So if we replace this value of this part, then this becomes, again f naught is constant, so f naught over m omega n, and value of this is 1 by omega n, so this is 1 by omega n 1 minus cos omega n t. And from here, this is f naught over m into omega n square 1 minus cos omega n t, and we know that the omega n square is k by m. So if we replace the value of this f naught over m, and at the place of omega n square we replace k by m, then this will get cancelled out, and this is 1 minus cos omega n t. So our xt becomes f naught by k 1 minus cos omega n t. So this is our response for a step function, and step function magnitude of that step function is f naught by k. So now if we understand this, the response is xt, we'll write here f naught by k 1 minus cos omega n t. So this f naught by k is static deflection, means if we apply a force of f naught, and this force is continuously there because we are not going to remove this, because F naught is this one. This is constant and it will continuously be there for the time. So this will be something like this. So we find out this is F naught naught by K, and here K was 3 EI over L cube. So this is static leverage. Now this beam will vibrate about this point. So first, because of this F naught, this will come at this point, and now it will vibrate about this point. So vibration will be something like this. This will come from this point and it will vibrate about this point, and this is static deflection. This is static deflection F naught by K. Now if the now we can say, if we find out dx by dt, to find out the maximum of this, we can say dx by dt. So for dx by dt, this becomes F naught by K and 1 minus sine omega n t. So we can say the maximum value of this omega n is 1 only. So this becomes 1 minus 1. So this becomes 2 times of F naught by K. So we can say this is the maximum value, and this is 2 times of F naught by K, and this is the new equilibrium position. Earlier the equilibrium position before applying the force, this was at 0. This was the equilibrium position, this was 0, and this is F naught by K, and the maximum of this displacement is 2 times of F naught by K, and that is this one. So if there is no damping, then this system will continuously vibrate with this. This is 0, this is 2 times of F naught by K, and if there is damping, then this will vibrate like this, and this will static or come at rest at the F naught by K position. So this is how we can find out the response of a single degree of freedom system against the step input, and in this case the step magnitude of that step was F naught by K. So this is all about the response of the system against the arbitrary force, and in this we considered the special case of arbitrary force, that was step input. So thank you.